think I'm, like, legally obligated to take Explorer Emeritus. That card is a sick amount of value. ERF TV Warp? Yeah, okay. We'll just go ahead and go with Explorer Emeritus. Because all of that value. He's essentially a staff of stories on a stick, which is, not unreasonable. Let's go ahead and go with it. Emeritus is always going to draw me a card, so I think that should be good. Alright, Ice Sprite is a tempting card. Not anything that really wows me. It's very, very vulnerable, but it does certainly lock down the opponent. Initiate of the Sands is also a good card here, and I think I might like that better. It's hard to turn down potential removal here. We gotta go with the Sprite. All of Lost Kings is probably the card here. A 7 cost 5/5 that's occasionally better than that. Eastwind Herald is also a pretty good flyer. Good defensive flyer. I think we have a chance of actually making a run at Hall of Lost Kings, though, so let's pick it up. Oh, and there's a Lumen Defender, so immediately, yeah, that goes in there. Excavate, that's life gain, but not life gain that we care about. Card disadvantage, I would say, is pretty bad in draft. It's got some potential. Excavating an Explorer or a Lumen is actually a pretty solid deal. We already have some decent advantage. We get to play Hall of Lost Kings again. I don't know, maybe we take the Excavate. Daggers is not any better, really, and Scaly Gruin's certainly not there. Let's not go with it. We'll pick the Excavate, and maybe we won't take it. Decay gains life. Carnosaur Behemoth is another way to finish out at 7. I think Yeti Snowslinger is the most exciting card here, just because 2-drops are good, and 2-drops that do good stuff. Fun Stable Form, that pretty much has to happen. It's decent value, it's a good Swiss Army Knife. Can function as removal in a pinch. Sometimes it screws you, sometimes it doesn't. Herald's Song for sifting. I don't like Herald's Song all that much, but I'm not sure I like Water of Life any better. I guess we'll take Water of Life. There's some life gain. I don't know, I'm not actually taking the life gain because I want it, I'm taking the life gain because there's no other options. Okay, what have we got here? Wisdom of the Elders, that's a pretty good card parody. Cobalt Acolyte works well with Snowslinger, and with big yellow creatures, which is where we'd like this deck to eventually go. I think Wisdom of the Elders is probably the first pick here. Predator's Instinct and Wild Cloud Snake, both good options. Cloud Snake currently has better synergy with what I've got going on, although Predator's Instinct does have synergy with Lumen Defender, as well as Hall. I've been burned for being light on removal before, I should probably pick up the Instincts. Okay, Bold Adventure is really solid. I think I like Cobalt Acolyte a little bit better. Give Things Flying, Violent Gusts are still pretty likely to be coming down the road. Sky Snapper versus Bold Adventurer. Tough call, but I'd say Sky Snapper here. Bold Adventurer is not to be undervalued. It's a very, very good card for just stymieing up the board. Maybe I go for the less aggressive strategy since I'm currently not sitting on anything major in terms of bombs apart from Hall. Tower Top Patrol, that will stall the board out for sure. I'm definitely not taking the second Excavate though. Elysian Pathfinder, what do you duplicate? Lumen Defender, Tower Top Patrol. Nothing great. It's some value. I think maybe Yeti Snowslinger is the better card here, but you gotta take the parody this early in. Jarl's Frostkin, good stuns. Second Sight. You get some echoes going on with Unstable Form, and I guess you get some life gain going on with Nomad Healer. Probably Frostkin's the better card here. These are all bad picks, though. Arachnodon at 6. Yikes. Jotun Warrior at 5. I'll take Scriggly Gruin. Cobalt Acolyte, yep. I really need some big creatures, because the Cobalt Acolytes are pretty helpful, but we don't have any aggression right now. Like, we're literally just relying on getting up to Hall of Lost Kings. Okay, Towering Terrazon, answering my prayers. No removal or anything here. That's the other thing we need to be looking for, so definitely take the Terrazon. Predator's Instinct again. Yeah, Continue to pick up some removal, fairly important. Another instinct, the Sanctuary Priest. I think Sanctuary Priest is pushing it. Let's take the instinct. All right, so that's three Predator's Instincts. We gotta get some big guys now. Another Tower Top Patrol. Goodness gracious. I think I'll take Unstable Form at this point. Maybe I can make some big guys. Another Tower Top Patrol. Okay. Beast Colors Amulet. Might take that on principle. I think Ornamental Daggers are pretty good here now that we've got so many beasties. Another Lumen Defender. What is going on? Another Predator's Instinct. I think four is... Is four too many? With two Lumen Defenders, I'm a little bit more inclined to take them. All right. Give me some real yellow beaters, though. Towering Terrazon. Yeah, there we go. This deck just got a lot better. Okay, Sand Form. I can use that to make more Lumen Defenders. I think it's also pretty good for... Yeah, it's a decent way to generate some good stuff. Nothing else good here? No. Synchronized Strike is a solid trick, but... Take Lumen Defender number 3? Yeah, why not? Life Gain, yo. All in. Ornamental Daggers is fairly necessary for our weird slow deck. This, we're getting counter-drafted here. This is not going well. Okay, I spoke too soon. Scorpion Wasp? That's very defensive, but it is good removal, and I think Sky Snapper is... I think we gotta go for Wasp. Okay, at this point I'm happy to take a Carnosaur Behemoth, because I know that I have nothing but delay in this deck. Unlock Potential, that's a card that I'm really looking for with all of the flyers that I've got. Elysian Trailblazer, what do you copy? I think you literally only copy Second Sight and Wisdom, which is technically good. I mean, I don't have anything better to do. Bold Adventure versus Infinite Hourglass. I think Infinite Hourglass here. What's our 2-drop situation looking like? 1, 2, Bold Adventure it is. Okay. Got the Infinite Hourglass anyways. There was a Yeti there, but I don't think that was right, even with a Flash Freeze and an Ice Sprite. And Felm Stranger is a 2-drop, I guess. Okay. Oh, we only ended up with 3 Predator's Instinct. I actually thought we had 4. Nope, there it is. This is a deck. Just go full life gain. Pathfinder has to happen, both Tower Top Patrols. Our blue is... interesting. Wisdom, for sure. Frostkin's a maybe. Explore Emeritus for sure. I think we stall out the board. I think we run Gruin. Cobalt Acolytes come in. Unstable Forms come in. Ice Sprite comes in. That guy. Now we're at 26 out of 45, right? And we're actually looking at solid 19 power. That might actually be a thing that happens. We don't have the Excavate in yet. Excavating a killer creature would actually be a pretty sizable amount of advantage. But we could probably do that. Did we put the Gruin in? No. That's a pity, because he'd be the first thing that I could take out. I kind of want to put Daggers and Infinite Hourglass in here, but maybe I don't? Unlock Potential needs to be in here, though. Seer's Companion isn't on the list. We have a very, very defensive set. I'm not sure if Cobalt Acolyte does that much here. I guess he gets a Snowslinger off the ground. Functions as an aggressive flyer and fixes Terrazons. So yeah, I guess you can stay. Pathfinder's probably gonna get some value, even though the creatures are less than enthusiastic about it. We're at 17. Throw the power in. It insists that I need more, I think that's right. Double Tower Top Patrol. Without any way to buff them. Nope, we got all four. All four instincts are in here. Oh, if you're suggesting that I take them down, I don't know. I think solid removal is going to help us out a lot here. Our win condition is just Hall of Lost Kings, right? Like, that's the way we win, that and getting Cobalt Acolyte up on our stuff. This looks pretty good to me. I'm not sure that there's a lot that I'd want to cut. Pathfinder, maybe. Yeah, Pathfinder, the creature quality is so low that Pathfinder is actually maybe not that great a deal. Double unstable form, maybe too much. Eh, I don't buy it. With the strength of my creature quality, with the ability to pop Aegises, the ability to turn creatures into other stuff, double unstable form actually is pretty reasonable, I feel. Can get you to a legendary 8 drop, which is fairly important. Your Lumen Defender is not doing the job, or your Explorer Emeritus gets silenced, or your Tower Top Patrol is just standing there. I like this. 46 out of 45. Let's stick with this. Yeah, Unstable Form is one of my favorite cards, and I think it's a pretty reasonable draft pick. It can be bad, but when our creature quality is this low, it's worth it to toss the dice. Okay, Bold Adventurer. Predator's Instinct. This looks pretty good, right? Yeah, Adventurer gets Instinct, maybe. Or maybe we just unlock potential on it. yeah, drawing a lot of Predator's Instinct is the thing that's gonna happen. Average stats for unstable form upgrades. You know, I was gonna create a program for it for a while, but then the unstable form deck came off. Stopped being a thing. I'm really sad that I don't have enough power to unlock potential and also kill stuff. I don't think we Predator's Instinct twice here. Yeah, that just invites removal. We can just unlock potential and Predator's Instinct again. Please don't play another power. Okay. Well, do I unlock potential here? Or do I Predator's Instinct after unlock potential here? Because Lumen Defender getting killer could actually save me from this wretched awakened student. I think we definitely do. Gotta get rid of this thing before it gets a ornamental daggers put on it, because there's already one down, right? Yeah, so he definitely has the second one. Man. Rough day. We're probably not activating Hall of Lost Kings, right? Lock there for sure. Myself a nice Carnosaur Behemoth. Yonder Chumps. I draw a power, or I stabilize at one health. Huh. Unless there's a teleport, which in all honesty, there's probably a teleport. Okay. Take that trade, Synchronized Strike. Well, that went pretty well, I would say. Just a pretty solid curve out from him. Our early drops aren't quite good enough to deal with a really solid curve out like that. This looks a little bit better. Same basic idea, Bold Adventurer on 2, Cobalt Acolyte on 3 though, which makes it significantly improved. Oh, Tower Top Patrol on the bar. Yeah, I'm pretty surprised by the strength of some of the draft decks that are happening right now. Do I just give this flying, since I'm leaving this guy behind the block. I'm always inclined to give the higher statted creature flying, but... Alright. Well, that's something. We just attack here. Tower top patrol would be really nice. So would a Lumen Defender. Perfect. Making some dudes. Not that big a deal. I don't know if I play Lumen or Explorer. Probably Lumen first, yeah. cheeky. I like it. That's fine. Not a particularly big deal. You can only attack with, like, one card here. And you don't really have a reason to. Oh, okay. Strangers lose quick draw, huh? Alright. That's a bargain. Let's upgrade. So. Do we go again? I don't think we spin again. I think we attack for four here. We draw our cards. Goodness. A lot of stuff. I'm a defender, please. Well, I have enough defense to make the aggro decks cry, and Kobold Acolytes are definitely swinging over the top. that's how we stabilize. Alright. I could also make a 6 drop out of one of these Lumen Defenders, but I think they're doing their job, so we'll let them be. It's a 6-2 now. Yeah, I think I have to put at least 3 points of pressure on him. Just make him, let him know that he's on a clock. And we're good to go here. Okay. This hand is only sort of gross. The fact that it hits 5 power is very appealing, and the fact that it hits something at 4 to help me get to 5 power is very appealing, but if I get rushed down, I get rushed down. It's party hour! If it's actually party hour, I'm going to cry. Oh, sorry, man. Yeah, I don't have a very good time on the draft ladder. My drafting's... I feel like my drafting's alright, but... Not the top tier. Which is a pity, because I really enjoy standard format, or drafting format, limited format. Yeah. We definitely take that. He's got a haunting scream, but Tower Top Patrol is way better. Oh god. That is a beating and a half. Do we unlock potential or do we play Lumen Defender, Terrazon? I think we play Terrazon and then we unlock potential? Eh. That's 10 damage we're taking in the meantime, though. It's a rough call. Well, I mean, now we have to play, like, actual cards. Namely, Powering Terrazon. Well, we could go Bold Adventurer Unlock Potential. That gets us some value while also allowing us to block. Yeah, that looks pretty efficacious. Okay. And now we just hold him off, right? He'll slowly bleed to death. We play our power for the turn. The ultimate answer to impending doom, Tower Top Patrol, block for 20 turns. I think I'm likely to get executed at some point here. Huh, what? Ooh, he's not willing to attack. That's really good news. No attacks at all. Okay, Terrazons then. I disagree with that. I think you should have put it on the impending doom. That doesn't give you a way to win the game. Okay. I'm gonna take that trade. That's interesting. Got a Lumen Defender here, just in case there's another Trickster's Cloak. I want to keep my life total pretty high. You got it in one, Sigis. Okay, so I'm probably going to give the Towering Terrazon flying. At least me a little vulnerable to attacks, but I don't think that I have a way to win this game otherwise. Ooh, what can I do with you? Quite a lot, it turns out. Maybe not anything this turn. I could go a little trigger happy with Predator's Instinct. I think I need to leave all my creatures up as blockers right now. That's unfortunate. I suppose that was guaranteed to happen though. Okay, well, Predator's Instinct here. Kills that. No Staff of Stories for you. And let's also not die of getting rushed. Oof. Alright. Draft's going well so far. considering how sort of desperate this deck is. Bold Adventurer, Kobold Acolyte, Excavate. Yeah, if I pull off the hull at least once, it will have been worth it, right? This is all of my three drops, so... Or all of my low drops. And I'm pretty short on low drops, so I should probably keep this hand. Hey, good job, Bliven. I don't think I made Diamond last season in draft. Okay, so Blind Storyteller is going to be a constant thorn in my side until I draw Predator's Instinct, and then I'm just going to pick it up. All lost kings. The dream's real, right? You just keep pressing the attack here, see if he trades. Ah, he traded. Nice. Yeti Snowslinger offers a significantly annoying drawback here. I just have to keep not taking damage. I'm gonna take damage here, but... Well, I don't know, maybe he'll block. Yeah, he took the block. Even trades. That's the way things are made. Let's see here. I could excavate Snowslinger. I don't think I should excavate anything. Not when I'm trying to draw up to Hall of Lost Kings. Playing anything here? Not playing anything, and also... I think that's a Scorpion Wasp, in which case giving Predator's Instinct would be a very bad idea. Let's just swing. Not a Scorpion Wasp. An ambush creature? I just didn't use Blind Storyteller for some reason. Okay. Oh, also didn't draw a card off Psionic Savant, so... That's dead. We are one power away from Hall of Lost Kings working. Draw it. Oh, come on. Come on. I want it. I need it. I gotta have it. Double secret pages. Getting up to that 4/4. Oh, he's using Eastwind Herald to trigger him. The dream. What? Oh, it's more than 25. I actually didn't know that. That's very sad, but it's not... Nonetheless, we have a 5/5. I actually thought it was 25 health. Anyways. It's all good, we get to excavate it. So, as long as he doesn't, push. And he can push, but he can't push hard enough. Hey, that looks good. Let's leave that alone for one more turn. Yeah, we couldn't have actually made the dream happen if we'd excavated, because we didn't have any way to excavate for a power. Well, that looks ugly. I guess he had no way to suspect that this was going to happen. Alright. Is that lethal? We're actually still a little bit short. He's got a lot of big creatures here. An ice sprite would help a lot. I am remarkably stuck, actually. I'm not sure if I can attack into this mess. I think I'm gonna lose. I don't know if I actually have a way to stop that freaking psionic savant from just wrecking me. I don't know, do we let him continue to stack the deck against us? Anytime he attacks with Savant, we get to swing back just as hard. Maybe harder. Alright, seems like a solid permafrost. Oh, thank god. Yeah, Wisdom of the Elders is gonna help out here. Sort of. He's pretty well covered on a lot of different fronts. I'm losing two of these 5/5s a turn. That's way better than what I was doing before. Alright, let's think this out. Five attacking, two of them get blocked. The remainder probably also get blocked, but they take out key targets of some kind. It's pretty close to lethal. I think we gotta do it. Let's not get killed there. Cool. And now we got not quite enough to swing in. Pretty close. Wait for that power, maybe? I don't know. Alright, how close to lethal is this? It's still pretty close to lethal. He's got a block with some of his flyers, but I lose some creatures again. Do we have a better stall out game? I mean, with Hall of Lost Kings, yes, but I've already played it. I don't have another unlock potential. Kobold Acolyte helps here. Oh yeah, I could draw Kobold Acolyte and start doing nasty things with Carnosaur Behemoth. I don't think I should risk the Carnosaur Behemoth for this turn. Let's just stay put. Hunting Terriax, you are an ugly flyer. Can't really do much about you. Oh. Right, I do have inevitability on my side with this card. Alright, you got some card draw of your own. Good times. Certainly your mid-range is looking kind of ridiculous. He actually draws out before I do. I think we stay put. Okay, good. A little bit more meat on the table. That is, I think, every high drop I have. <laughs> 17 to 12. Can't play better than this, right? Lumen Defender. Very important card here. Another Lumen Defender. If I get a Predator's Instinct, I can actually start making some plays. And I will get a Predator's Instinct. That should allow me to start pushing through. Yeah, I only have one Excavate. I don't think I played two. Maybe I have a second Excavate. If I do, it's fine. It actually doesn't help me all that much more here. Well, I mean, it gives me the way to win the game. But a predator's instinct would as well. What you doing, Jeebus? Trying to decide where ornamental daggers go. I like it. Alright. So... got a scorpion wasp here. Okay. Good. Get push with this one, and maybe this guy as well. I think deadly creature attacking is not a bad idea here. Just reduce the amount of blockers he has. Yep, we do have a plan for if my opponent removes Ice Sprite. Interesting, he's looking at like a really significant block. This has Overwhelm. No, it doesn't. Oh, okay. Lightning Strike. Still, that's pretty close to lethal, right? Yeah, I actually thought that I did play the power. I must have just clicked on it and then not actually played it into the field. That's fine. 5, 5, 6. So there's 4 attackers here. Anything that I want to turn into a huge beater? I don't think so. I think we're probably okay with what we got. Let's just swing. We broke the backbone here. We're in pretty good shape. I like how he's still running out of cards before I am. How did that happen? Like, what? Where did he draw so many cards from? Oh, secret pages, right. And blind storyteller, that's it. All of the ways to enable Psionic Savant. Well, he's got to make a play on my Ice Sprite soon. If I'd attacked with everything, it would have been lethal? No, not quite. I would have missed one. He would have blocked with that Eastwind Herald. And, yeah. Okay, let's consider unstable forming something. Maybe a sentinel? Yeah, I mean, a six cost creature is probably better than a sentinel. Unless it's an Arachnidon. How about a 7 cost creature? I'll take it. that should put us over the top. Already Lou. Alright. Good grief. What a game. Snowslinger. I think this is good enough. It's got a 2-drop, it's got a Predator's Instinct. It's got Haul, which I don't care about too much, but legendary fella. I don't think anybody played a legendary. I'm pretty sure that there weren't any legendaries in that game. Okay, Explorer Emeritus. Or worst synergy with Predator's Instinct that you can imagine. Probably fine trading a Snowslinger into a Stranger. Since the objective here is going to be to buff the Stranger, right? Oh. Okay, even better. We'll just give this killer. Murder that thing. Because who likes getting rushed down by district infantry? Absolutely no one, that's who. Tower Top Patrol would be a good draw here. Lost Kings, you have to have more than 25 health. I thought you could have 25 health and still be fine with all of Lost Kings. Maybe they changed it. This seems like a bad move on his part. I don't know, maybe you didn't have another option. I think we give this flying. I can snowball that, but it won't actually fix my problem. Oh, the legendary is, yeah, Nightmaw. He's a 7 power 7 7 that has your units are unblocked. You've got it right, evasion. He's one of the various 7 cost cards. Oh man, if I unstable form, it won't have flying. I think I explore Emeritus here. Also, I'm really sad that that's got an extra 1 toughness from somewhere. That just fills me with sadness. Goodness. Alright. Well, I get to block that at least. How do I have to answer this? Lumen Defender is part of it. Can I draw the other half? No. No, I cannot. Yeah, I know where he got it from, I'm just sad he has it. Not sure if that was the right call. Okay, seems fine. You Tower Top Patrol. A lovely card right here. Stalling out the game. I think we Hall of Lost Kings for the 5-5. I would have definitely gone for the card that, No. Okay, well this is gonna die. So let's go ahead and turn it into a 6 cost. I like it. Round that out with a Lumen Defender. You get the value. Could have maybe unstable formed there, but I don't know. Seemed like killing that 2-2 was probably going to be helpful to me, especially since now I get all of the stuff back from the grave. You have a plan here, sir? Alright! I'm for it! He saw the value and he couldn't resist. Don't think I should have drawn last turn with Emeritus? Why not? No, I guess, I mean, I could have turned it into something that could attack, but card advantage, man. Like, I knew that the 6-6 was going to survive the weapon no matter what. Okay, Bold Adventurer, Emeritus, yeah. This looks pretty good. Oh, goodness. Well, this is not likely to... Alright, we're back up on the, I think I Sandform Emeritus here? He doesn't have that many ways to actually remove Emeritus. In fact, I think he has none. So if I play him down, I actually get a pretty sizable advantage out of that. Oh, I could have attacked there. Whoops. Save my scorpion wasps for very valuable targets. Do I attack here? Nah, we can stay put. Protect our health. Alright, we'll probably have to wasp that. Ah, but Emeritus is such value. I think it might be better to Emeritus. What are we doing here? We holding the line and just risking it with Psionic Savant. Psionic Savant is the real killer card, right? Like, we don't have an answer to that, so we just need to... I think we ignore the Serpent Trainer and, yeah, Emeritus. Emeritus, it is true. Because it's got merit in it. Oh god. Alright, well that's a bigger creature than I expected. But still not that scary, right? We just draw into a Tower Top Patrol. We're fine. Everything's fine. I could excavate a sand form. Oh, I like that actually. Excavate a sand form. Don't attack with Emeritus. And there we go. That allows us to trade with one of his flyers. And also draw us some cards. Draw us some cards. He hasn't hit his Psionic Savant yet, so I'm pretty happy about that. Fair enough. He didn't actually get to see that trick last game. So, good stuff. And the engine turns. You know, if I had Psionic Savants, I would definitely be in a much better situation than he is. Okay, we have Tower Top Patrol finally, so that's good news. I think we can actually pull off... We can pull off... what? What can we pull off? We can pull off something good. Hall of Lost Kings can happen. First we must draw a billion cards. Do I drop Scorpion Wasp here? It's not unreasonable. Defend our life total, we get a free trade out of it. Can Predator's Instinct it later. Alright. It's a weird block with Scorpion Wasp, but I like it. Might be a synchronized strike going on here. He's thinking about something. Okay. Gets a sort of even trade out of it. I think that mostly went my way. There's Hall. Play Lumen Defender here. Could give it Predator's Instinct, but I don't know if I need to kill the flyer all that much. Attack with this now. That seems fine. Start pressuring him a little. Why not draw some more cards? Come on. You can do it. Hit that other Lumen Defender. Okay, you're not quite going for it. I mean, I understand. We'll probably just play down at Terra's on here. Oh god! I think I'd rather do that than trade anything else into it. Emeritus is a delightful card. And since we're going to be saying Emeritus a lot, we're going to practice saying Emeritus instead of Emeritus. I apologize to people if things don't go that way. Or for saying it wrong for so long. I do know it's Emeritus, I just wasn't paying attention. What? Why? Why would you silence that and not Emeritus? Are you that afraid of Hall of Lost Kings? Because I'm getting Hall of Lost Kings. That's happening. Alright, well this is mostly useless to me, so let's turn it into something cool. Lifesteal Charge? Not bad. Better. Well, that was a weird game. Here we go again. Emeritus, an unanswered sort of Emeritus, is just the worst thing in the world for an opposing draft deck. You don't have the removal, you just don't have it. Yeah, I think it is a delightful deck. I'm really happy that it's gotten this far after losing that first round. You pop a serious curve on it, and I think it just dies. I mean, we drafted it right. Like, I didn't feel like I made any mistakes during drafting. We just didn't end up with good cards. Hooray, my phone is fixed. I had a job interview, like about a month ago. And it was a phone call interview. My phone chose that particular moment to die. So I had to, like, send it off and, like, go through, like, a whole bunch of problems with it, with the at the Verizon store, and didn't really like the experience all that much, but they it was still under warranty, so they sent back a box, and box had a new phone in it, so I just took the back off my old phone and sent the old phone back, and the new phone had like a bunch of bloatware on it, and it was kind of weird, and every once in a while, instead of like making sounds like a phone normally makes, it would instead just go and not stop until you remove the battery. And eventually it just shut down completely. So I had to go to the Verizon store again and do that whole mess again. And the time that it shut down the second time around and stopped being useful was directly before my next job interview. So, you know. Anyways, this one seems to be looking pretty good. It's still got the same bloatware on it. I think that's just standard on all of the phones now. But, hasn't malfunctioned in any way that would give me cause for concern. Alright, the fact that he hasn't played anything on turn two, means that I might have a pretty decent chance at this game. Pretty much any time when my opponent doesn't actually have— oh god. Okay, my deck is far too slow to handle that, but it does have a lot of beefy flyers, so I just have to draw one of those. Unfortunately, we are flooded out at the moment, and being flooded out against Recurring Nightmare in draft is, you know, well, being flooded out against Recurring Nightmare in general, not a fun time. Good gosh. I could unlock potential here. I don't think it's worth it. we're just gonna get slowly beaten to death by recurring nightmare. Is that a 8-8 now? Is that 8 or 4 at the moment? All right. If I can unlock potential here, then that'll be good. Yeah, Scorpion Wasp would help, Tower Top Patrol would help. Can I attack here? Nice. Probably have to take the 5, which is really unfortunate because... we're actually above 25 right now. So if he keeps developing stuff, I could, like, draw into Hall of Lost Kings and win. That's not a recurring nightmare. That's a recurring nightmare. Alright, not attacking with the sauropods. I've got the board gummed up on the bottom. I just need Tower Top Patrol. Let's see if we can get a flyer. That doesn't save us. But it does prevent the recurring nightmare from killing us for a turn? Oh yeah, that's okay, actually. Because then he can't, okay, yeah, no, this is a plan. He's really... if he doesn't see it, then it's pretty good, but I've actually signaled what I'm going to do, so we'll see if he plays into it. Oh god. Okay. Stop drawing power! Why? What's at 6 that flies? It's not much. If we can actually check that real quick. Eternal.cards. Units at 6. Mystic Ascendant, Carnosaur, Arachnodon, Hatchery Raider. Northwind Herald would happen. Mistville Drake could happen. Horse Snatcher Bat could happen. I can't kill it by doing anything bad here, so I think we probably form. Let's do it. Hatchery Raider. Well, that's unfortunate. Yeah, I'll take the trade here. Won't I? 8, then 16. I guess it's lethal either way, right? So maybe we don't take the trade here. Whoa there, Hambone. If I'd had my unstable form, I could have killed you. But no flyers. That was a huge mistake. I could have had any number of things that could have killed that recurring nightmare at that point. Alright. Snowslinger. Yeah, this is worth keeping. It's a little bit weird. I don't like the fact that it's only got 2 power, but we've got 19 power in the deck, so... we're fine. Everything's fine. We get to Kobold Acolyte Snowslinger, and then we start doing some form tricks. Probably we do the forms on Kobold Acolyte, because we've robbed Kobold Acolyte of its inherent flying value by giving it to Snowslinger. And we still got Predator's Instinct and Lumen Defender. Yeah, this now looks like a really good curve to us. Yeah, this could be a desert marshal. Maybe I shouldn't have bothered. It is only an uncommon after all. Okay. Stable form. Do I give him a 5-drop? I could. I think that's a little bit unnecessary, though. Do I use Cobalt Acolyte? That is definitely unnecessary. Let's swing in with these two, or do we unstable form again? Let's give myself a 5-drop. Okay. Looks good. Whew. Looks real good. Forgot I had a snowball. Coup de Grace work with Recurring Nightmare? Yes, it would. Wait. Yeah, no, because it would give you another attack step. At the very least, you could attack with it, return it to your hand, put it down, and then Coup de Grace. So even if they, even if it doesn't work out the way that you want it to, where Coup de Grace would just automatically recur Nightmare, you still have to play it anyways, so just play it again, then Coup de Grace. Do I kill this? I might kill this. Ah, well, no, the Xenon Guardian is just too easy to deal with Lumen Defender. Yeah, we could test and see if it actually allows you to, Yeah, nothing but quality here. Okay, what can I excavate? Stable form? Eh. I gotta say, I'm really tempted to just give the Soulfire Drake Killer just to kill it. Okay. And I'm not playing down Cobalt Echo 8, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, no point to. Yep. Killer, Infiltrate, and Aegis all refresh when a creature is revived. Is that it? Do we win? Are we all done? Is that 3 diamond chests? One more game. Okay. Let's do it. The final round. Unfortunately, it's not against Jeebus again. Although, that was a good matchup for us, actually. Since we like to dirtle, and we're better at dirtling than he is. I don't think I keep this. It looks okay. Okay. Not much better. But could be worse. We get 2 blue, then we can Wisdom for real cards, and Cobalt Acolyte might actually get us somewhere. Something I can play. Okay, that's... We won't play Cobalt Acolyte just to get a 2-1 flyer. We wanna save it for our bigger creatures if we can. Okay, here we go. Power Top Patrol? Or Snowslinger? Snowslinger. Let's develop that first, and then we can Cobalt Acolyte and get a Snowball. Or maybe we can just attack with our Snowslinger? We're looking at something. Okay, that's probably the least threatening silence. I really like it when people Desert Marshal Snowslingers. Also, why would you do that? Are you planning on attacking? Planning on giving it like a thing? Okay. Now it's a 4-4. Yeah, rough day. That's gonna make Hall of Lost Kings just a little bit difficult. But not impossible. Guy attack here. How are you at 20? Did you gain health from? Healer's Cloak, got it. Hmm. Okay. We're very close to the dream. I kind of want to kill Aspirant. Just because it's pretty threatening at 8, but it's probably better to get rid of that. Yeah, my deck would love a Healer's Cloak, it's true. And it wouldn't be like a huge deal for it, but on a Tower Top Patrol, Healer's Cloak is just tops. Alright, we have to protect our Hall of Lost Kings, so this happens. I think we're gonna win the final round of this draft on Hall of Lost Kings. I think that's how this ends. That's kinda sweet. Everybody's got Predator's Instincts. Come on, draw that less power. Give it your best. No. No, we did not. We could Cobalt Acolyte here, but I might as well save it as a surprise. Yeah, we'll put this up on YouTube. Alright. That went pretty well. I will say that I particularly enjoyed this particular draft. You know, I've got to put some drafts up on YouTube that aren't just silly ones at some point, because, like, man, the last three have been kind of silly, but yeah, that is an Elysian draft that went exceptionally well despite not having exceptional card quality. We just picked some good synergies, and it went pretty good. Alright, prizes. Ooh, shiny Nomad Healer. And, you know, commons, but nonetheless. Ah, shiny Silverwing Familiar. That's pretty cool. Okay. Nothing great in the premiums, but still looks pretty good. I really want to get a legendary premium at some point out of one of these chests. Okay. Nothing too special there. Anything shiny here? We're mostly looking for shinies at this point. We have everything else except for like 11 legendaries. Nothing special here. Yep. There you go. The dream.